So I started playing saxophone when I was six. I'm coming from a musical family. My father is a saxophone player, tenor, and my grandfather was a saxophone player as well in the early 50s in Chile. So I started studying with my father, mainly alto, for many years. And he had a very particular, and I think that was, now I realize how lucky I was to have a crazy man like that. He, you know, besides he teaching me all the, you know, all the scales and all the theory, like he didn't want me to learn how to read music. He wanted me to learn everything by heart. So he always encouraged me to think about everything that I was doing, you know, even if he was playing like major scales, like rather than explain me, okay, major scales, the modes and the intervals, like he will make me analyze each mode. And then he will tell me the names, you know. So that way I absorb all that information very deeply since an early age. And the other thing that he did is that he made me transcribe like countless solos of Charlie Parker by heart. And back then, and this makes me feel old, because back then we used to use radio and cassette. And you know, like that is what I mean by crazy. Like he will sit down hours and hours and you know, play on the cassette and then sit down with me and go phrase by phrase. And it wasn't necessarily about the notes. Like he made a lot of emphasis on how Charlie Parker was playing. So I was actually learning about sound and about time feel and you know, the language since a very early age. And so the whole idea of transcribing, again, it wasn't just about the note, but it was about to learn about concepts that can really be explained, you know, like what does it mean to have a good sound? What does it mean to have a good time feel, you know? And now as I'm older, I always encourage my students to go to the process of transcription. But when I'm talking about transcription, I'm talking about transcribing for real. It's not about the notes. It's just about like really getting to under somebody's skin and trying to understand how that person expressed himself. And the other thing that I really, that I think that is important as a younger musician, you know, like there's no such a thing as having a good sound or bad sound. It's everything is personal, you know, so we all have to go through a process of, you know, learning the history of our instruments so we're well informed and we're able to talk on our own. But by having heroes, people that you admire, it kind of give you a sense of understanding of what you like, if that makes sense, you know, like what are you going for? So you can have a vision. So when you practice all the technical parts, when you practice sound or when you practice rhythm, you have the concept, you know, because one thing is that you practice the sound with the tuner. Okay, you're in tune, but where is the concept, you know? And that, I think that those two things, like, you know, working on long tones and doing all the boring things that we have to do and then transcribing, is they should go parallel, because you know, it doesn't matter if you practice the scale with the metronome on 40, if you understand the feel behind it, you know. So once you have the feel and the concept in your head, you can polish that through practicing and have a sense of direction.